Now come to validate the unsolved pools of pending. Here we have to calculate validation of unsolved pools. Right. Come to follow the procedure here. Number of goods consigned. How many goods we are consigned? 100. Right? 100 that minus number of goods sold. Here sold 80. We got 20. Right? Unsold goods at the rate of cost of each. Unsold goods is 20 at the rate of cost of each. So we have to calculate cost of each only the consignment cost only. That is nothing but 300. No need to consider cost of sales of our own 400. We have to calculate this in unsold goods by using each cost of 300. No need to calculate 400. We got 6000. Right? Under the act, first one, expenses of consignor. So this equation is unsold goods divided by number of goods into expenses of consignor. Right? Unsold goods 20, number of goods 100, expenses of consignor. Here, expense of consignor 1000. I can define it as 1000 into unsold goods 20 divided by number of goods 100. 21 sir, 25 sir. 1000 into 1.5, you get 200. Right? And next one plus direct expenses of consigning only we have the same equation mark unsold goods divided by number of goods into direct expenses of consigning. Right? We can observe direct expenses in the consignment equation. Here we have direct expenses of consigning. Consigning is nothing but borrowed 1000. 1000 as freight. Freight is nothing but direct expenses. So 1000 into unsold goods 20 divided by number of goods 100. 21 is 25 is 1000 into 1.5. As usual, we get 200. So total value of unsold goods 6400. Right, this unsold goods will be converting into credit side of consignment import 6400. Right, so all transactions are entered perfectly. How to see once again? Goods entered consignment completed. Invoice price 20% extra price will be converting into debit side. Cost of return also 6000 will be converted into credit side. Right? All expenses and commission is also completed. Unsold goods also validated. Now come to finalize the values. Here 38 plus 44,400 in debit side. Here we have to see 36, 37, 38, 39. So now we can observe here 44,000 here, 42,700. We can convert the 44,400 here minus 42,700,001. 4 minus 4 is 0. So 1700 we got here. This 1700 we have to mention as to profit on consignment, right? And come to the next one. Next to procedure debit and credit. Now we have to see consignment report is in every problem auditor, but in the second proforma we have to check it is consignment report or consignee report. Here prepare consignment report completed. Varun's report. Varun is nothing but consignee. So we have to prepare consignee's report. Mention consignee's report in brackets. Name of the person Varun. Here particulars. Total amount, particulars, total amount, right? Already you know how we have to prepare this consignee's account based on consignment account. Here consignee expenses will be converted into PL, right? We have to see first one, direct expenses. Why? Direct expenses in brackets, that is freight. Value 1000, right? And next one, by indirect expenses in brackets, godown rent, that is 1500. And next one, commission 10% on sales to VP is nothing but consignee. 10% commission. 3200 only we have to enter, and one more is by advances to consignor. In this problem, we don't have any advance payment by the consignee to consignor, right? So debit balance will be converting into perfectly in credit side of consignee's account, and come to here. Here, sales of consignee. This value will be converting into here. To sales of consignee Varun 32,000, right? And come to forward the values 32,000 here, 32,000 here. This value 3,4,5,5,700. Have to check advance, 100 books, 20% invoice completed, flight 1000, 1500 golden rent, commission, so we don't have advance. Credit side, here perfectly entered, 5700. This value we have to call, I mean, of this by bank or cash or draft to balance capital, right? And come to the last one. So in this proforma, we don't want to check any procedure. Directly we have to give the goods, send them on consignment account. Here already you know only one transaction we have to enter, that is goods sent on consignment plus invoice price also we have to enter. Trading or material, that is 100 machines at the rate of 300 plus 20%. Invoice price, that is 36,000. Right? Here we don't have any transaction. We have to convert this into total cost 36,000 forward into credit side. And here we have to calculate 36,000. This 36,000 we have to call by consignment. Right? This is the problem regarding unsold goods, direct expenses, as well as invoice price. These are the most important problems in your consignment account. Based on these four problems, definitely you will get one problem in your final examination.